Welcome to my channel IGCSE Chemistry. On this channel you will find simplified videos of short lessons of chemistry, not only for IGCSE students but also for other students who want to learn the basic concepts of chemistry. Today we are going to learn about mole, Avogadro's constant and molar mass in very easy way. What is mole? As we know, in our daily life we need some units for measuring something, for counting something. For example, we can measure apples in kilograms, we can say a pair of shoes, and we can count eggs in dozens. So what is mole? Mole is a chemical counting unit. Actually, it is used to count the chemicals, for example, chemical substances. For example, we can say 1 mole of hydrogen or 1 mole of oxygen molecule. But the question is now, how many grams are present in 1 mole, right? How many grams are present in 1 mole of substance, or how many particles are present in 1 mole of substance? Let us understand it. So here, in this chemical equation, you can see it's a balanced chemical equation of decomposition of water into 2 moles of hydrogen and 1 mole of oxygen. So in this equation, what is happening? I will write the moles now. It means there are 2 moles of water. They are breaking into 2 moles of hydrogen and 1 mole of oxygen. So this is giving us a simplest ratio between them. This is 2 moles of water, 2 moles of hydrogen and 1 mole of oxygen. This is how we can say that moles are chemical counting units, because we cannot weigh the chemicals as it is not convenient for us. If we write the opposite equation, hydrogen plus oxygen, it makes water. When I will balance this equation, it will become like 2 moles of hydrogen react with 1 mole of oxygen and makes 2 moles of water. So again, I will tell there are 2 moles, 1 mole and 2 moles. Now our question is, the grams are present in each mole. So each mole of any substance, 1 mole of any substance, it has how many grams? The grams are equal to the relative molecular mass of the substance. But we have to take care, either we are talking about atom or molecule or formula unit. For example, when 1 mole of hydrogen, this is, you can see this is atom, it's not a molecule, only hydrogen. So in periodic table you will check that the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1, relative atomic mass. So I will write here 1. It means that 1 mole of hydrogen has how many grams? 1 gram. Very simple. 1 mole of hydrogen molecule, this one is now H2 molecule, it has how many grams? Because there are 2 atoms joined together and it is a molecule, so I will take 1 times 2, so it will be 2 grams. It's very simple. 1 mole of hydrogen molecule has 2 grams. 1 mole of water has how many grams? I will calculate the relative molecular mass of H2O. How? Like this. H times 2 plus O. So H, here you can see the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 times 2 plus 16. Here you can see 16. So I will add them together and I get 18 gram. So this is very easy to calculate. 1 mole of any substance has how many grams? So the definition now comes to the point, 1 mole of substance has mass equal to its relative formula mass in grams. Relative formula mass, as we represent in MR, right? So it means that 1 mole of any substance is equal to its MR, or relative formula mass. And if we are talking about atom, so it is equal to atomic mass, mean AR. Now we have to calculate 1 mole of calcium carbonate. Here I have given to you the atomic masses of calcium and carbon and oxygen, you can see. So I will calculate for you now. 1 mole of calcium carbonate has how many grams? Calcium has 40 plus carbon has 12 plus oxygen has 16 times 3, 48. So I will write it 16 times 3. I will add them up because I will take the sum and it will become 100 gram. Similarly, I will count for carbon dioxide. 1 mole of carbon dioxide has how many grams? Carbon has plus oxygen 16 times 2, and answer is 44 gram. Okay, next is, we got to know now, mole is a chemical counting unit. Yes, we know that. 1 mole of substance has how many particles? Now another question, that 1 mole of any substance has how many particles? So it is very easy answer. 1 mole of different substance contains same number of atoms or molecules or formula units. It means that any substance we are talking about, it has same number of particles. Particle could be atoms or molecules or formula units. It depends on that substance about which we are talking. And that number is 6.02 times 10 raised to the power 23. And this is the fixed number. So now we come to conclusion that each mole, 1 mole of any substance. Now if we are talking about atom, for example carbon, carbon is an atom. So how many particles mean how many atoms are present? 6.02 times 10 to the power 23 atoms are present in carbon atom. If we are talking about hydrogen molecule, now this is a molecule, so same number of molecules. If we talk about formula unit, for example NaCl as is an ionic compound, so it has same number of formula units, 6.02 times 10 to the power 23, and you have to learn this number, and this number is called Avogadro's constant, after the scientist who discovered this number. So this number is called Avogadro's constant. So we come to know that 1 mole of any substance has 6.02 times 10 raised to the power 23. But why we have written atom here? Because we are talking about carbon now, and carbon is an atom. So 1 mole of carbon has this number of atoms, and how many grams? This number of grams, yani 12 grams of carbon. So 1 mole is equal to relative formula mass in grams, and 1 mole is equal to 6.02 times 10 raised to the power, and 1 mole is equal to 6.02 times 10 raised to the power 23 atoms. So what is molar mass? By this way we come to conclusion that molar mass is actually relative formula mass, yani MR, in grams. Okay, when we were talking about only relative formula mass, you know there is no unit for relative formula mass, but when we express this in grams, now it is called molar mass. It means the number is same, only we use different term. And also molar mass has a unit, gram per mole. Gram per mole mean 1 mole has this much grams. So molar mass of carbon atom, now you can easily find out what is molar mass of carbon atom. Carbon atom 12 gram as equal to its relative atomic mass. Molar mass of oxygen molecule, okay, we are talking about molecule, so it is oxygen times 2. So I will write here 16 times 2, it becomes 32 gram per mole. And molar mass of sodium chloride, NaCl, Na, atomic mass of Na, sodium is 23 plus chlorine is 35.5. I will calculate them and it will become 58.5 gram per mole. Okay, gram per mole. I hope you understand now. How many atoms are present in 1 mole of carbon atom? How many atoms? The number is 6.02 times 10 raised the power 23 atoms. How many molecules are present in 1 mole of H2O molecule? Same number. How many formula units are present in 1 mole of NaCl? Again, same answer. It means number of atoms or molecules or formula units, they are equal, same, and they are called in one mole of any substance, and they are called Avogadro's constant. If you like my video, please like and subscribe and share, and thank you so much.